My name is Jordy Bohannon. I'm an English teacher at Appalachee High School. I've been working here for 7 years. I teach AP language to 11th graders and reading support to 9th graders. I'm also the student council sponsor, assistant girls, basketball coach, co-sponsor of the International Travel Club, and the academic coach for the football team. Well, on a daily basis, I typically wake up around 6:30, leave the house at 7:15 in order to be at work by 8. Throughout the day, we have an hour and a half long blocks, three for instruction and one for planning. After school, I typically am out the door by 5. Obviously, during basketball season, that time becomes any time between 6 p.m., 10 p.m., often later. So with our 8-to-4 workday, I'm usually here at least one extra hour and often a few more after that. I really enjoy teaching high school because I think students are at this really interesting moment in life where they are still kids, but they're preparing for what's gonna come next, whether they're going to enter the workforce or go on to college or even join the military. So they're at this really transitional phase where I think you can have a huge impact. When it comes to building relationships with students, I think that care and respect is just like the ultimate cornerstone of that. You have to show them love and care and respect in order to get that in return. In order for them to trust you. And I think trust is a huge component. One thing that I want people outside of the profession of education to understand about teaching is that teachers are experts in both their content area and the science of pedagogy. I think a lot of people assume that because they went to school, they understand what teachers do. But what you see from a student perspective is so little of the whole picture. So a lot of my lesson planning happens during my planning block each day, but I also have a 45-minute lunch duty during that time as well. And this is one of the spaces where our professional learning communities are really helpful because we're able to meet as a group on a content area team and really get a lot of that work done together through that collaboration or split that work up. And so I think the biggest challenge with planning is asking ourselves, where do we need our students to go? What do we need them to know, do, and understand? And then the plans become like how we get them there from where they are right now. It's tricky because those plans are always changing. They have to be flexible and they have to be reflexive and they have to move, which is what makes it difficult because it's something you have to work on every day rather than at the beginning of the unit or at the end of a unit in order to revise for next year. The first thing teachers have to do is be willing to decenter their own experiences and themselves in order to prioritize the experiences of their students. I think successful teachers have to believe that all people can and also want to do well both in the classroom and in life at large. And then on a more literal level, oh gosh, there's planning and instruction and collaborating with our peers and analyzing data and building relationships and hearing about heartbreaks and giving advice and, oh wow, that's just so all of the above.